What was your last job?
Sir, I was interning. Before that, I was working with a company which is US based as a project coordinator.
So, why did you wish to join civil service?
Sir, there are a couple of reasons. The first and foremost for me is that it offers a great career opportunities for anybody who's professionally inclined. And since I worked for a few years, I realized that I would be able to perform the job that it demands. And so secondly, it would also give me an avenue to kind of understand what I can contribute to society in a more direct manner.
Right. So what qualities do you possess which will make you a good civil servant?
I have an optimistic view of life, and I like to believe that I am a people's person. I usually am able to get along with people from across diverse areas, and that's one of the traits that a good civil servant should possess, because they interact with people from across backgrounds. And so apart from this, I'm empathetic towards people, so I am able to understand where they're coming from. And sir, also the fact that I have the capacity to persevere and not give up. So even if there are certain obstacles which might crop up, I would be able to see a task through to its logical conclusion.
Is this your first attempt?
So this is my last attempt.
Ms. Sharma,
yes,
have you heard of the Malabar Naval Exercise?
Yes.
What is that? Can you tell me something about it?
Yes, sir. It's an exercise between amongst a couple of nations, which is the charge is led by India. There is a participation from US naval forces, also Japanese naval forces, and in the past we've also invited the Australian forces.
Yeah, on occasion. But the, it's basically a trilateral exercise.
Yes, sir.
Very good. What is the purpose of this?
Sir, we are Indian Ocean for us is a natural backyard. And it is necessary that we keep on developing our capabilities in the Indian Ocean region. And this exercise allows us to collaborate with countries which are apparently doing very well.
So is the Malabar Naval Exercise only held in the Indian Ocean region?
No, sir. And one of the regions where it is taken.
Where was it held last year?
Sir, I don't seem to recall. But
off the coast of Guam, which means Western Pacific.
Western Pacific.
North of Australia. So, but you're right, it was basically three countries on a few occasions.
Yes.
Australia has also been invited,
yes,
and once Singapore had also been invited.
Yes.
Okay. There's also something called the Milan Naval Meet.
Yes, sir.
Which, what is that?
So, Milan, wherein even the countries from Southeast Asia also participated. It was a much larger platform.
Much larger.
Yes, sir.
And it is, where was it held? It is the Andaman and Nicobar Command, which hosts it.
Yes,
that's right. Okay. Now, you know, there is a scheme for regional connectivity called Udaan.
Yes, sir.
What can you tell me about that scheme?
Sir, India is trying to make a foray in the global aviation market, and we're at the same time also trying to explore the domestic market. So the idea is to connect the underserved and unserved regions of the country and provide no-frill airports so that the regional connectivity overall is improved.
And what about the ticketing? Is there any
yes, sir,
fixed price?
So there is a cap of 2500 on there is a certain criteria.
Right.
Yes, sir.
And how and the funding called the
viability
gap fund,
yes,
by the government, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, you know, you heard of the International Court of Justice?
Yes, sir.
Now, recently, there are two judgments which they have given. One relates to Mauritius and the Chagos Islands.
Mm-hmm.
Are you aware of that?
I have not read about it.
Okay. The other was, of course, relating to Kulbushan Jadhav. So, why did we go to the International Court of Justice in this particular case?
Because as two countries have not been able to come to a conclusion with respect to this particular case, and we hope that the International Court of Justice would be able to give a favorable verdict.
No, so what were we trying to do which Pakistan was denying us?
Yes, sir.
In respect of Kulbushan Jadhav?
Yes, sir. Return of.
No, we were trying firstly consular access.
Yes, sir.
They refused to give it to us, right?
Yes, sir.
And then they sentenced him to death.
Yes, sir.
So that was the reason we had no other option but to then approach the ICJ.
Yes, sir.
Now a hearing was held in the ICJ very recently.
Yes, sir.
What happened in that?
Sir, they were not able to come to a conclusion and the talks will continue to go on.
No, both sides gave their final statements. And the court will give its judgment in due time.
Yes.
So the hearing is over.
Yes, sir.
The courts will now give a judgment. Okay, now you know, in December, January,
yes,
a number of youths were arrested by the NIA,
yes,
for being radicalized on the net and becoming supporters of the ISIS.
Yes, sir.
They included some people from UP, Delhi and Punjab. So, what is this ISIS?
Sir, ISIS is a non-state organization which expands to Islamic State of Iraq and Syria, which had a huge hold in terms of control over the oil fields, which was trying to create a caliphate in the West Asian region and expand it to the larger global, to gain a footprint.
And what was the, who was the leader?
Abu Bakr
Baghdadi, right? So, do you think that they pose a threat to India also because of the fact that they are able to radicalize so many Indian youths?
So India has very, very strong ethos of secularism and democracy and communal harmony. But at the same time, we need to ensure that there are enough safeguards in place so that we need to undertake de-radicalization exercise.
Okay, right. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Ranjeeta, in the recent Swachh Sarvekshan,
yes,
Faridabad did fairly well. You are from Faridabad,
yes, sir,
right? Now that was one factor which contributed significantly to its occupying a higher position than the last survey.
Yes, sir.
What was that area?
So to my mind, it is solid waste management and door-to-door collection of the waste and segregation at source.
Good. You are right. What are some of the unitary features of the Indian constitution?
Sir, the fact that we have an integrated judiciary, our election machinery is integrated, and similarly the mechanism of audit under Comptroller and Auditor General, and also the All India Services is also an integrating factor, and we have a unitary bias, that's where we have a unitary bias in the constitution. Because, for instance, even the Finance Commission decides
the terms of reference for the states. So you are leaving out one of the most important provisions of the Constitution, which is unitary in feature. Emergency provisions?
Yes, sir. Emergency also.
Okay. Now, what according to you are the strengths and weaknesses of the Indian economy today?
So to talk about the strengths, that we've become the sixth largest economy and we are growing at a very rapid pace. We have a demographic dividend.
There has been some deceleration recently in growth.
Yes,
but still, yeah, you are right.
Yes, sir.
We are still the fastest growing.
Yes, sir. In the last 5 years, we have upped the game. We've gone from 12th position to now 6th position.
Yeah.
And the demographic dividend is second. And we are the largest. We are the most attractive destination for foreign direct investment. And so we have a strong banking system and the availability of investment. So these are some of the positives that I can think of.
Low inflation.
So inflation, under the inflation targeting, is being managed properly.
So that's a strength.
Yes, sir. The macroeconomic indicators are doing fine, and even in the forex, sir.
Okay, now come to the weaknesses.
Yes, sir. So some of the, so the fact that the banking system, because of its rising apart from this, we have unemployment is also one of the problems that Indian economy is facing. And lack of, there's a certain amount of crowding out effect, and private investment is not catching up.
No, low private investment.
Yes, yes. And we've not been able to exploit the entrepreneurial potential that the country has.
What about our performance in the trade front?
So we only account for just about 1.7% of global trade, and we have a long way to go as far as foreign trade is concerned.
Okay. Do we have a positive trade balance or?
So it depends on case to case basis. For instance, with
overall?
US. So overall, we are an import. We're still importing more than our exports.
Okay. Now, do you know anything about the National War Memorial?
Yes, it has recently been inaugurated in Delhi.
There was some negativity associated with it also.
Sir, I'm not aware of the negativity around it.
You didn't read in the newspapers the Prime Minister's speech making use of that occasion to deliver a speech which had political overtones that was criticized in many quarters. What is Vande Bharat Express?
Sir, I'm not able to recall. I've read about it.
Train 18?
Yes, sir. The train 18 has
the same. Both are the same. So, if you are familiar with train 18, so tell us something about it.
So, train 18 has recently been started. It is relatively at a higher speed and with the latest technology. However,
what is the speed?
So, I'm not able to recall this exact speed.
Would you call it as part of the make in India effort?
Yes, sir.
Where was it manufactured?
Sir, I'm not aware.
Integral Coach Factory. You have played handball at a fairly state level and junior level.
Yes, sir.
Is handball part of the Asian Games schedule? Is it included in the?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Why is it that our performance has not been very good in handball?
So there are multiple factors at play. There are institutional factors that our federation has not been doing very well. There is a lack of adequate investment in the sport overall and particularly in handball. And the talent search has also not been up to the mark. And apart from this, there is a lack of overall culture in terms of sports, how we perceive sports. So it is not still seen as a viable profession, so to speak, and people are still averse of taking sports as a career.
It hasn't assumed a mass proportion
yes.
as yet,
yes.
Limited to few states, and it hasn't gone down to the grassroots.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
You've written trekking as a hobby.
Yes.
Where all have you trekked to?
Ma'am, I've been to Rishikesh once, and in the recent past, I've trekked in Himachal. There's a small cantonment town, Subatu. So I've trekked from Subatu to Dakshin.
So what's the difference between trekking and hiking?
Ma'am, trekking is usually taken on an uncharted, arduous terrain, while hiking is undertaken on a well-laid-out path.
So did you have to do some training before you went on a trek?
Ma'am, I usually walk out and I go for a run, so that helped me manage the challenge as well.
Okay. And you've written journaling. What is journaling?
Ma'am, it's just another name for your diary writing.
Is it the same as journal writing? So then why is it called journaling? Is that some new technique?
There is a lot of confusion of new technique wherein people maintaining online journals.
Mm-hmm.
But for me, I usually maintain a diary and I undertake a stream of consciousness writing.
Okay. Now, since you're from Haryana, tell me the status of the Khap Panchayats. Are they legal bodies?
Ma'am, they are not legal. They are extra legal. And as per the Supreme Court judgment, the Khaps have been asked to not give diktats in terms of which can lead to honor killings.
So why is there such a stronghold of these Khaps on the people there?
Ma'am, there's a strong caste basis for Khaps. The caste associations form groupings, and that's how village elders come together and form Khaps. And they've traditionally held a great sway over people because they've acted as means of social control, wherein they would give out messaging wherein people would be asked to not perform certain tasks. So it's largely because they have been there as a caste association.
So have they also given some positive directions?
Yes, ma'am. There have been definite positives.
Let's hear the positive directives given by the caste.
For instance, there have been directives against dowry and alcoholism, domestic violence, and also the recent Beti Bachao Beti Padhao mission has also been propagated through a...
What is this Beti Bachao Beti Padhao and why was it required?
I mean, in India overall and in Haryana specifically, there has been a skewed sex ratio and there has been a greater effort by the government to improve the sex ratio overall.
So what comes under the Beti Bachao?
It is...
is there some act? And the Beti Bachao?
Yes, ma'am. PCP and DT Act and also medical...
So it's been implemented?
The administrative bodies are trying to implement it in spirit and letter.
And under Beti Padhao, is the Haryana government also doing something other than the central government scheme?
Yes, ma'am. There is a Sukanya Samriddhi Yojana which is underway through which you can deposit certain amount in the bank right when the daughter is born. And then that money can be withdrawn at a later
stage. Is the Haryana government also doing something?
Ma'am, there is a Ladli scheme also.
What is the Ladli scheme?
Ma'am, this is for, if I recall correctly, it is for the education of girl children.
Now, since you had sociology and you were talking about caste, what role does caste play in our society? In general, not just Haryana, but in general.
Ma'am, caste plays both positives and certain negative roles. The positive is that it gives you a sense of association. People can identify with the caste. But at the same time, caste has been a divisive element in Indian society. And it has led to inter-caste conflict. And also, it has also certain connotations wherein it leads to disempowerment of women under certain castes.
So, would you say that the family structure is changing over time in India? Or has changed over time?
Yes, ma'am. The family structure is undergoing transformation in India. There are new forms of family which are coming up. For instance, we've traditionally had joint families. Now we are looking more and more nuclear families are coming up.
Why? Why is that so?
Because more and more people are migrating, moving out, gaining mobility, and for their career, for their education. So, and that is where they would want to remain close to their workplace and have a family.
But they also say now there is a concept of jointedness of families.
Yes.
What does that mean?
That is wherein you call back your parents to stay with you. So there is a thrust on children being taken care of by the grandparents when the parents are away at work.
Okay, fine.
Thank you.
Thank
you.
Ms. Sharma, yes, sir. How do you look at the problem facing Indian agriculture?
So there are several problems that Indian agriculture faces today. Some are anthropogenic, some are climatic. For instance, the erraticity of monsoon that we face, Indian agriculture has been at the receiving end of it. Apart from this, the problems such as the declining productivity and declining yield of Indian agriculture. There has been increasing use of chemicals such as pesticides and insecticides. And fertilizers also.
Farmer is not getting regulatory price.
Yes,
that's
sir.
An important thing.
Yes,
right?
Yes, sir.
Recently, the budget,
yes,
new scheme was introduced.
Yes, sir.
Tell us briefly about that.
So the scheme was called PM Kisan Nidhi, Kisan Nidhi Samman, under which the government would give out 6,000 rupees annually in three installments of 2,000 each. And this would essentially be for the farmers who have access to land and access to titles.
And how is this money to be disbursed? What is the mode? What is the mode of disbursing?
Sir, if I understand correctly, this would be through DBT.
It will be through DBT.
Yes, sir.
Right. And what kind of problems are expected to come while implementing this?
So we still have not been able to digitize. Our land records, the modernization program has been underway. However, the land records are still not available for a lot of states. And sir, it could also require a certain amount of cooperation among the center and state because states.
Yeah, yes. Right. Anomalies are in the news.
Yes, sir.
In what context and what exactly is the problem right now?
Sir, recently Haryana Assembly has passed a law which was in a way amendment to the previous law, which was Punjab Land Preservation Act, under which they are opening up the forest area to non-forest purposes. And this would also.
And how much land is we talking about?
It's a 60,000.
60,000?
Yes, 30,000. I stand corrected.
Okay. So, what exactly is the direction given by the Supreme Court?
So, the Supreme Court has put a stay on the law and asked the state government to not go forward with it. And there need to be a requisite amount of studies and research on the ground so that the land is, the forest area is not opened up for
it. You are from Faridabad, right?
Yes,
sir. MSME sector is quite important in Faridabad. Right?
Yes, sir.
What is the importance of MSME sector to the country?
Sir, MSME is one way of ensuring inclusive and balanced regional growth, because that is where the people at the grassroots can come together and work in factories and improve their standard of living.
What are the problems facing the MSME sector?
So the first is that they have lack of credit. The credit is not available. Secondly, the standardization is not there, so their products do not meet a lot of quality standards. And so also the infrastructure availability, such as power, transport is not available.
Has government done anything to revive this?
Yes, sir. One is through Make in India program, the government has put a stress on MSME sector. Apart from this, there is schemes such as food fees, such as in the budget also, the government increased the limit of public procurement through MSMEs, and also, sir, the promotion of
GST, the threshold has been enhanced for the MSME sector, right?
Yes.
From 20 lakhs to 40
lakhs. 40 lakhs, yes.
Okay. Last question.
Yes, sir.
Elections are around the corner.
Yes, sir.
How do you assess the performance of the Indian of democracy in India? Some areas of strength and some weakness.
Sir, democracy is so fundamental to India. They are really synonymous to each other. We conduct the largest electoral exercise in the world, and we are the largest democracy. And the voter participation is also increasing. There have been so many electoral reforms in the past.
Some weaknesses?
Sir, the vote bank politics and voting based on caste associations, certain primordial entities, rather than looking at the development as an issue. And certain marginal communities are not being talked about still in our election discourse.
Right.
Thank you,
sir. We're talking of democracy in India.
Yes, sir.
Which institution has been the strongest pillar of democracy?
Sir, there wouldn't be a single democracy. The democracy in India is a result of a collaboration and cooperation among multiple pillars. For instance, Supreme Court of India, the Institution of Election Commission, the CAG that we have, and sir, UPSC.
Of these, UPSC hardly has any role in democracy. However, of the remaining three, which is the strongest according to
you? Sir, the Supreme Court of India.
Yes. But for Supreme Court, we would have destroyed democracy. There was a very serious attempt, at least in Indira Gandhi's time. Even in present NDA government has tried to destroy institutions in a big way. Only Supreme Court has stood firm. Right. Mass communications is your subject. How will 5G promote mass communication? 5G, you've heard of
mass communication? Yes, the wireless communication.
Will it promote mass communication, and if so, in what?
Sir, it would, the fact that we already have Digital India going on, it would increase the speed with which the information is disseminated. The infrastructure is already being built under the Digital India program, and if we can meet the targets under it, we would be able to harness the benefits of 5G also.
What is the state of digital literacy in India? In rural sector, in rural area, and in urban sector?
Sir, I do remember the number for rural India, which is close to 35%.
You're talking of internet connectivity, 30%, which is mostly mobile.
Yes, sir.
They are using now.
Yes, sir.
But that, not digital literacy. Digital literacy, what do you understand by digital literacy? How do you define digital literacy?
That individuals, the citizens, are able to access the service which is provided online and are able to, in a secure way, and have the knowledge of accessing the secure pathways.
He knows how to operate a computer.
Yes, sir.
To communicate, yes, sir, through digital means, to receive communications, that is called communication, to create digital content.
Yes,
sir. This is what it is. Yes. To understand digital content.
Yes.
This is the meaning of digital literacy.
Yes.
Now you tell me what is your state of improvement and urban.
So overall, we have a long way to go. Because
that,
even
that is a very very diplomatic statement, but doesn't state anything. Our, it's very poor. 8% in rural area, about 24% literacy.
Thank you,
sir. Did government launch any program for rural literacy?
Yes, sir. Pradhan Mantri Grameen Digital Sakshrata
Disha.
Disha.
PMG
Disha.
What was the target and what was achieved?
So 6 crore
in 6 insuring. Crore, you're absolutely right.
Yes.
How much was achieved?
So that number I'm not aware of.
Only 54 lakhs or 57 lakhs. 19% only. Now, should there be a regulation of the internet? Is it required in India?
Yes, sir, because it affects the public life in a huge way. And we need regulations so that the purpose of internet usage can
so
be.
So, regulating the net, will it not dilute the principle of net neutrality?
Sir, we can regulate it and ensure that everybody has same kind of access. So, that would protect the net neutrality.
That's not the correct answer. These are two different concepts.
Yes, sir.
Net neutrality is different from
yes,
net regulation.
Yes, sir.
That's what you should have said. What are the laws which are used for internet crime, for combating internet crime? What are the laws?
It should be under IPC, but
what
I'm
is
not. Indian Penal Code.
All right, IPC, absolutely right.
And CRPC.
And
CRPC.
There's another law.
And sir, IT Act, Section 66A. Yes, IT Act.
Yes. Now, what are global commons?
So global commons are the, it's a notional, it's an abstract concept wherein it could be the space, it could be the environment, it could be the forest resource we have, it could be the cyberspace, which everybody would have.
We are going to many unconfirmed areas. There are specific areas which are called global commons.
Sir,
be specific.
Oceans is one.
Yes, high seas.
High seas, yes.
High seas, not exclusive,
yes,
economic zones or
yes, high seas.
High seas. What
yes,
else?
So
which
space,
everyone uses.
So
nobody,
space.
No country owns, but everyone uses.
So
outer space. Not this space here,
yes,
or near space.
Yes.
Near space belongs to the country.
Yes, sir.
What else? Antarctica?
Yes, sir.
Cyberspace?
Cyberspace, yes.
You have done English literature.
Yes.
Do you remember anything of it? Can I ask one or two questions?
So I do my best to answer.
All right. Now, who is your favorite author in English literature?
Sir, Khalil Gibran.
English literature?
Yes, sir.
In English classics. Khalil Gibran is not English.
Sir, so he's written in English also.
Khalil Gibran hasn't written. Charles Dickens?
Hard Times.
Robert
yeah.
Browning?
Yes, sir.
You read?
I've read.
Robert Browning?
Yes, sir.
Any poem you remember? Lines, important lines from literature?
So, lines I do remember.
From quotes of Shakespeare, one or two important quotes.
To be or not to be? That is the question. You're right.
Does Supreme Court make laws?
No, sir. Supreme Court the legislature makes laws and Supreme Court testifies it under the constitution framework of Article 30, judicial.
Does the acts of Supreme Court have the power of laws?
Yes.
Under what articles of the constitution?
Article 13 of judicial review. And sir, outside of constitution, sir, public interest litigation that it takes up under its
141, 142. Article
141, 142.
Are you aware of 142?
Sir, this is
SLPs. 142 says that in order to do complete justice, Supreme Court, in order to do complete justice, that is, Supreme Court has the authority to issue any order, directive, decree. That is what has the force of law. It is binding on everyone in the country. That's why nobody challenges Supreme Court. Well, we close interview and give you a little feedback. Most questioning we feel would be based on your verdict and death. And that is where questions you should expect. Haryana is one, sociology, English literature, mass communication. These are some of the areas. Then constitutional principles. I have asked you only one or two questions, but there can be other, like basic structure concept.
Yes.
You were asked about unitary features.
Yes.
Most important unitary features are emergency powers.
Governor.
Second is overwhelming power of parliament in the three lists.
Yes.
Then due process of law, etc. is an important concept. Sociology is your subject, and then current affairs.
Yes.
These are some of the things. Now, one or two things I'll just quickly point out. Indian economy.
Yes,
neither demographic development nor employment are part of the economy. The benefits of a good economy will lead to better employment, etc. So they have nothing to do with it. We have great dividend, therefore we have a great economy. That's not economy is a certain subject. Neither employment are part of it nor demographic dividend. Remember this. And don't say India is a great destination of FDI. FDI, how much was it in 2017-18?
Sir, last 5 years is close to $45 billion.
No. 2017-18 it was $48 billion. About 49 million, but this year it is declining to 35,000 crores. It's coming, 35 million, sorry. It is declining this year. So don't say this. America remains still the biggest recipient of it, not India. India is a poor recipient of it. China gets more than this. So these are some of the areas where you should focus your attention. Okay.
Okay.
Doing well, continue with your studies. All the best.
So, anything specific that I need
to,
other than these, I'm preparing. I
have
prepared questions and
I'm working on this. Everything else in your favor. You have good personality. You can talk nicely. Your expression is good. Just check up your pens and strengthen your pens. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon to get latest updates on upcoming videos.